back, eh? How's it going?
Take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Such beauty in the midst of nothingness.
What's new? Do you have time to talk? I had a favor to ask. Thanks. This has been swirling in my brain goo for a while now. So, I've been pondering over what's happened and what it all means. And I've got a favor to ask. A teensy-weensy favor. About the size of a Planck lamp, really. I think it's time I joined you in the physics bending powers business. See if one of those temples works for more than just you. What, you think you're the only one who can walk around in a cape and tights? Granted, it's just a theory, but I venture anyone who experiences visions from touching an artifact is now connected to them. You got a vision, I got a vision. You got a power, ergo. Marvelous. I'm glad you're as gung-ho about this as I am. As it so happens, I've already talked to Vladimir. Seems our eye in the sky is back up and running. You sent me the coordinates for the temple already. We just have to visit. What's on your mind? Oh yeah, I do. You may as well have it now.
Yes? You need something? And just what is on your mind at this moment? We will speak again soon, I hope.
Freezing. insanity,
this is
you know?
Got to be joking. Nope. Okay. Skipping the initial shock of it all. Agreed. Not worth it. Forming a hypothesis. You know, my captain asked the same thing. Different captain, though. So you aren't an exact facsimile. From my readings, you don't have your appendix, and you're a quarter of a centimeter taller than me. Minor differences, but fascinating. I wonder what else is different. That doesn't make sense. Cloning is a complicated procedure involving a lot of complex science. This was... a whole lot weirder. That's one way to put it. Me. Accurate. I'm just, passing through. Molecular binary schism? Temporal twinning? Group hallucination? Don't forget the fluctuations in the energy patterns, which align almost deterministically. Harmonized vibrations distorting some mechanical barrier between neighboring universes? Impossible to know with such a minute subset of readings. We need more data.
Obviously.
I'll be Barrett Prime. Amundsen is fine. Usually the barrier between us is too thick to communicate much anyway. Amundsen? Now I know you're not me. Hey, one of us has to keep it classy. Why stop at two? It won't work. The energy required increases exponentially per anomaly. I'm already exhausted. In a way that's hard to describe. Not physically or mentally, but something else. Sorry, friend. You'll feel right as rain when I dissipate. Whoa, there. Sustaining this connection requires a lot of concentration. Is this permanent? You will eventually monitor the energy fluctuations and agree. But no, this is unusual. I could study this forever. Irvin told me to just enjoy it and collect data on the side for later. And I'm glad I did. Irvin? He's with you. He's... okay? By the tone of your voice, I'm gathering some things in our lives might be a bit different. Is he... is he happy? Yes, he is. Our daughter pilots the ship after Vasco was destroyed. But otherwise, we've survived the war well. Aw, man. I only hope the new one we're building is just as salty as the last one. Amazing. Sounds like you don't have a daughter here, I take it. No. We talked about it, but... no. We named her after Aja, my mentor. She died in the crossfire between the United Colonies and the Free Star Collective decades ago. For me? Irvin died instead of Aja in that crossfire. She's best friends with Cora. And she's smart as hell. Of course she is. Going on 20 years now. But we're starting to turn the tide. Imagine all of the variations. It's endless. It's been so long. The horror of the infinite is the inclusion of the unimaginable. I promise. He's happy. We're happy. I have so many questions. I wonder how many paths I've taken. We've taken. How many variations. How many ended with heartache and how many with joy. I think about that all the time. Wait. What's that noise? Starborn ship. What happens for any of us? I don't think it works that way, though. Maybe I'm just a construct or a memory. I don't know. But I don't feel pain. Good to know. No idea. This isn't how the power works for me. I've never had a conversation with myself before. You pretty much know everything I do now anyway. More than I ever hoped for. We can handle this. On it. So look, for the record, I am the same Barrett that came here with you. For sure. I think. Is the ship my secret lair then? I guess. I would have preferred something with more seating. And maybe a fireplace. Something cozy. Oh well. Hey, at least I didn't pull an army of knees out of thin air, right? Imagine that. True. How would I stand out in a crowd made entirely of myself anyway? Anyway, it's a relief, you know. I have this ability, this power, and I'm still just me. Just regular Barrett. And they already feel like it's subsiding. I no longer feel like I'm in a huge crowd. Yes, though it takes a lot of concentration. If I do it a lot, I bet I'd give myself a headache. From myself. I'm my own migraine. I thought so too. Other me, other Barrett, seemed like he was able to handle himself well in that fight. Anyway, we'll see. If the other me gets in the way, I can just release him or stop using the power entirely. For now, I just need to use this power a bit and digest what all has happened. Sure, but give me some time. I want to use it a bit more. See what its limits are. I just need some time with it. I lost my Irvin. I know that. I wish beyond anything that he appeared in that temple instead of me. But it helps to know there's an Irvin out there somewhere living a life full of love with someone like me. I can move forward with that thought in my heart. That's pretty exhausting, really. So I might only do it when I feel like we could use backup. For now, anyway. Need something? Okay.
Geological samples to contribute? Yes, I am. I've been out here for weeks without anyone to talk to. Most of the pilots I've tried hailing have either shot at me or flown off. My food and water supplies are fine, but I didn't bring nearly enough books to keep myself busy. You can only read Pride and Prejudice so many times. After my third time through it, I started using the pages to teach myself origami. A tragically understaffed one, yes. But this geological survey could earn us a big grant from the UC government, assuming I manage to finish it. A tiny staff means a tiny budget, so the only ship the Institute could afford to send me out in was this bottom-of-the-line junker. It's been slow going at best. That's why I've started hailing pilots like you for assistance. I can't thank you enough. I'm in the market for lithium, platinum, and vanadium right now. I'm not asking for much. I know they're hard to come by. I understand. Thanks for stopping anyway. I'm going to try my luck in another system. You might want to back up a bit. This old junker's grav drive is a little on the fritz. Fly safe! Sorry, this is taking longer than usual. So, do you have any hobbies? If you haven't tried it yet, give origami a shot. I've been folding paper birds and flying them across the ship in zero-G. Personally, I have quite a rock collection. I used to spend my weekends gathering samples on Jemison. Maybe I shouldn't have let that slip at the office, huh? That's probably why they sent me on this job instead of some poor grad student. You ever hear the one about the geologist and the music shop? It's a good one. A geologist walks into a music store and asks the cashier, "Got any rock?" The guy looks him up and down and says,
It's no different than any other business.
You know, I needed this. Exploring the galaxy with you by day, investigating the mysterious legal woes of my long-dead spouse by night. Fasco never appreciated my humor that much. I was just remembering how I'd pour my heart out to Fasco so many times. I told him all about Irvin. He showed me a chart of how sad I should expect to feel. Why not? Trust me, I've talked to way less sentient humans before. Vasco's just fine for most conversations. Sure, folks from the Lodge, folks from my past. I've got friends when and where I need them. But traveling with you has been different. We're more of a team. It feels stronger. He was really hoping the visual presentation would help. It did not. Oh, we got to point B many times just fine. Top-notch co-pilot. Would recommend him to anybody. Anyway, I'm glad you're here right now because we have things to discuss about Irvin's case. I heard back from my contact. They looked into Hephaestus Mining Corporation. Looks like they paid off the judge. And that's not all. My contact really came through for us. Turns out the witness was threatened until he withdrew his testimony. And thanks to our contact, we now have the receipts. Contact has an audio log with the identity of the speaker verified, time-stamped, everything. Bank transactions. A precise amount was transferred to the judge only the day before the ruling. No, my contact does for now. I trust them. We worked together a long time ago. And it depends on what I want to do with all the proof, if anything. I'm glad you're confident already. I'm not, though. I'm worried we don't have enough evidence to go up against a massive corporation like that. So I know a cyber runner who has accessed corporate archives before. They can dig into the classified archives before we go to a lawyer. We can pay extra for them to use less legal methods to obtain information, but that adds risk. I appreciate that, Captain. But I'll take care of any fines or bribes that come up from this. You have always been so supportive of me during this process. Let me take care of this part. Depending on what they find out, it might be time to talk to a lawyer. I'll see if I can find one. Whew. Taking on Hephaestus isn't going to be easy. And I say this as someone with actual superpowers. Why couldn't I have gotten something more useful? Like the art of cross-examination. Might have come in handy at the trial. That's solid advice. Know your actual limitations, and not the ones granted to you by a mysterious superpower. Anyway, let's go adventure while we wait on the cyber runner to get back to us.
Now that you're a legend around here, I'm going to tell everyone it was me who recruited you. Why? Is there anything new worth stealing? Because it would have to be pretty tempting for me to leave the key now. Not that shaking the Carl Fieldings of the world for loose change isn't its own kind of fun. But with the legacy, we're dealing with matters on a whole different scale. Back to it then.
You see, you'll never crush the fleet. They'd have to catch us first.
Stopping sister, with the legacy in hand, the future is looking bright. I'll probably stick to gathering intel. All the yo-ho-ho and other pirate bluster isn't my style. But that doesn't mean I won't drink a pint with my fellow swashbucklers to celebrate our victory. Most days, though, I prefer a cup of tea. Until we meet again.
Glad you didn't make me look bad.
We may not have official security on the key. They're always looking for trouble.
Shinya says you've been tearing up the mission boards. Gonna take a lot to beat your high score.
You see, putting quite the effort to keep that comp spike business quiet.
Thanks for making me look good. I would have had to kill you
with the creds flowing from the legacy. Now we're back to the planning phases, so no big jobs for a while.
Damn, do you ever sleep? Aren't there roses you could be smelling somewhere?
Look, I know what Dale said, but if you ask me, I think your next move should be to head down to the Nova and get yourself a drink. You've more than earned it. Hit me up if you got questions.
Nice to be back on the key for a bit.
Mm-hmm.
good to come back to the place everyone wants you dead.
Nev and I might have a quiet celebration. Sometimes it's best to steer clear of the Nova. Catch you later.
Every captain here's earned their stripes, bleeding for the fleet.